The electric field at a certain point is equal to the electric field force per unit charge. In this figure for a dipole, the electric field lines where they are very close to each other, the electric field is strong. Where the electric field lines farther away, the electric field is very weak. The electric field for a positive charge, the electric field is away from the charge. The field for the negative charge is away from towards to the charge, as you see here. And the electric field is tangent to the electric field line in every point, as you see here, here, and here. The another physical quantity is potential difference. The potential difference between point A and B equals to potential energy difference between point A, B, and A per unit charge. The last and important physical thing is equipotential surfaces. Equipotential surfaces is a surface on which the potential difference is the same at everywhere. As you see in this figure again, the blue lines represent the equipotential lines, as you see here. A point charge, when we move the point charge from point A to B, no electric. When we move a point charge from point A to point B, no network is done. And another thing we have to say, we need to say about equipotential is that the equipotential surfaces is perpendicular to electric field lines each point, as you see here, here, here.
This experiment is to show the equipotential and electric field lines between two electrodes. We have two sets of electrodes with different shapes and a multimeter whose probes are in my hands, as you see. We apply 5 volts voltage difference to the electrodes. We can show at where the equipotential lines are with the help of conductive paper. We will map the equipotential lines nearby one electrode in the area middle of the electrodes and nearby other electrodes. First, let me show you how we can make measurements with multimeter by measuring the potential difference we apply to the electrodes. As you see, it's almost 5 volts difference in the area between these electrodes. Let's check a potential nearby this electrode. It's 1.44 volts. We can draw the scheme of electrodes and put this data on the scheme on a millimetric paper. We will move the probe until the desired potential indicated on the voltmeter. As you know, electrical potential change opposite proportional with the distance. So, when we get further from one electrode, it will decrease. We will search the 1.45 volts. When we connect the points, we will obtain an equipotential line. Let's check another equipotential line between these electrodes. We can take 2.27 volt and put this data on the scheme. These are equipotential lines with different voltages, as we measured. Let's find a third one nearby the other electrode. When we check the lines, they are almost linear as you see. As you know, the equipotentials are with the same shape as the source. Let's check the same thing with the other set of electrodes, which have a different shape. Let's pick a potential and find equipotential lines again, 1.43 volts, this one. So, we have a linear equipotential line nearby this electrode. As the second measurement, we can pick 2.33 volts. As you see, the shape of the equipotential lines are changing according to the shape of other electrode. Nearby the second electrode, it becomes a curve in the shape of that electrode. So, we can see equipotential lines behaves according to the source which creates them for both of the sets of in here. In the second part, we use this relation between potential difference and electric field. The distance between the probes will be R dx, and with this dx, we will search the maximum change in the potential difference to find the direction of the electric field. One probe will be pinned and With the other probe, we will search direction of it. As you see, potential difference gives a maximum value in a specific direction. We put one probe to the point we find and search the direction of electric field again. According to the theory, we know that the direction of electric field is perpendicular to the source alignment. Let's check if this is true at another point in somewhere else between these electrodes. It's almost linear, as you see. Electric field is perpendicular to these linear electrodes. Let me give an additional information here. We can see if the direction of the change in the potential difference is same with the direction we measured it by looking at the scale of voltmeter, as you see. If it's minus, the direction is opposite. If it's plus, it's in the same direction with the change in the potential. It also gives the direction of electric field to us. We are doing same thing again with the other set. When we take tangent of this circular shape of this electrode, the electric field is also perpendicular to tangent. So we prove the theory in this way. We can see it more properly when we put the data on the scheme.